Breaking It Down with Frank McKay. This is 103.9 LI News Radio.
I'd like to welcome everyone to Breaking It Down. This is Frank McKay, but more importantly, film director, filmmaker Paul Lazarus is my very special guest. You know him from his episodic work, episodic television, but I won't put words in his mouth, but I imagine many people are going to consider his next work or his current work his most important. The name of the film is Slingshot. Paul, how are you?
I'm good. Nice to be here.
Well, Slingshot, it blew my mind, and I saw the trailer, and I saw the film, and I appreciate the heads up on it. Can you give everyone a synopsis of what we're talking about?
Yeah, the movie's called Slingshot. It's a documentary, a feature-length documentary, and it's really about the inventor, Dean Kamen, who most everybody knows because he invented the Segway, the portable scooter balancing device, is what he's most famous for, but he's recently worked on a machine called the Slingshot, as in the David and Goliath story, which can really take any form of contaminated water and turn it into safe, clean drinking water. And it's a phenomenal device, and it's had trials in Africa and South America and Mexico already, and it's capable of basically saving lives and getting clean water to people who have really no access to it. As long as you have a water source and a little bit of power, which can come by electricity or solar or even biomass, you can make clean water. And what's fantastic about it is it's a point-of-use solution as opposed to a big super plant that cleans water. You can take it to a little village in the rural Ghana and start making clean water for people, and I witnessed that, and it's just an incredibly hopeful device and solution to the growing world crisis on water. So I'm very excited about it.
To me, it looks like a game changer. And I'm a layperson. I'm not a scientific person. I'm not up on on as much as I should be on the environment. But to me, I would imagine that people are getting very excited about this in that community. Are you getting are you getting raving people about what's going on with this film?
Yeah, I mean, well, on some level, it's still too much of a secret. You know, it's hard to get people to come see a movie of any kind, and harder to get people to watch documentaries. But we're excited because the movie's going to get out on Netflix to 15 languages, and it's going to be on iTunes in the fall, and we're going to have a limited theatrical release starting in July. So I don't think it will be as much of a secret after all of that. But right now, I hope, and my fondest desire is to have millions and millions of people see this, because I think it is a game changer. I think that people are just now becoming aware of how serious the world's water challenges are, and this is a device that really speaks for the people who have no access. We're going to, in America, we'll probably be able to do desalinization, and we'll have the money and the resources and the power to create large plants that turn ocean water into potable water. But in parts of the world, which are many, where they have no access to clean water, this device is truly, as you said, a game changer, because it can be plunked down and start making clean water for about 100 people's needs. And to be able to do that with any device in this day and age, I think the word game changer is appropriate.
Paul Lazarus is our very special guest. If you're just tuning in or if you're just turning on your radio, this is Frank McKay, but more importantly, wonderful, brilliant filmmaker, and it's a brilliant, hyperbole aside, brilliant film. Slingshot is the name, and to me it's very important. And Paul, it's easy for me to say, but when you mention millions of people seeing it, I guess from a filmmaker standpoint and everyone else, they want that to happen, they need that to happen. I'm thinking in my mind, if just a couple of key people see this, Elon Musk or people like that see this type of I was going to say contraption. It sounds like the wrong terminology, but if they see this technology and they get behind it, this changes the lives of people who don't have clean water. And you're talking about you're talking about millions and millions and billions
of people. They say it's about 800 million people don't have access to clean water around the world right now, and it's growing. And unfortunately, we're polluting the water at such a rate that it's growing and growing. But yeah, I do know that Bill Gates, who's one of those people, has been made aware of the machine and the technology, and we'll hope that we'll hope that he will get behind it. And but one thing that happens is the more people see it, the more likely the Elon Musks of the world are likely to see it. So I'm starting with the grassroots sensibility of let's get a whole mess of people to see this, and then maybe it will get, it will rise to the top and be seen by the people who make those kinds of decisions that can help the really billion people who need it.
I ran across it on YouTube. I mean, how great is YouTube? And I reached out to you because I was blown away just by the trailer. Can you give a site where people could check out the trailer?
Yeah. I mean, the easiest way to track what's going on with this is join our website, which is very simple. It's the name of the machine, Slingshot Doc, like documentary, slingshotdoc.com. And, you know, there you can see the trailer and you can actually be made aware of where screenings are taking place. And also, if you give us your name and email, we'll keep you posted on what's going on with the movie and with the machine, which we're starting to really do now and on a large level. But yeah, come join. This is a problem that's going to affect everyone, and it's particularly becoming close to home. I live in California, in Los Angeles, and we're the victims of a severe drought, and there's all sorts of water rules being imposed on L.A. right now, and, you know, there's problems all over the country about water. It's not just, I like to say, it's not just over there. It's right here.
Are there people kind of segregated in your group, in your film group, your organization? For example, some people are concentrating on the business of promoting it for this. Is there somebody in particular, is there anybody in particular that is concentrating on those key individuals, the Bill Gates, the Warren Buffetts, the Musks of the world, or for that matter, even the, you know, making sure the Red Cross sees this or the Greenpeace sees this?
We don't have the staff to take on that kind of approach, but, you know, I believe the DECA Research, which is Dean's company, I believe that they target very key people to help distribute and mass produce the machine, and they go after them, you know, with clear goals and purposes in mind. So, yeah, I think it's happening, and I don't think it's nothing that Bill Gates has flown to New Hampshire to see the machine. That doesn't happen lightly.
Right.
I think the answer to your question is yes. People are being targeted. You know, I'd love Matt Damon and Gary George, who run a group called Water.org, to know about this machine. And ironically, there was a program on the Gary Rose show. Is it Gary Rose? What's his name?
Charlie Rose?
Charlie Rose, sorry. Charlie Rose had a TV show, and on the show, the first half hour was Dean Kamen and a few other people talking about the slingshot, and then the second half hour was Gary White and Matt Damon talking about their water.org. Unfortunately, the two half hours were filmed separately, so they didn't cross paths. But it's those kinds of people who are concerning themselves with addressing water stress around the world that definitely need to know about the slingshot and know the story and know what it's capable of. We're doing our bit to get it out as much as possible, and we're hoping to spread the word a lot in the coming year.
See, I would imagine, and going back to the Charlie Rose show, I would imagine it wasn't an accident that those two segments got put together. I mean, I tend to believe there's no accidents, especially, I'm sure it's a PBS. It was a PBS show?
No, that was Charlie Rose's own show. You know, that was his hour, the Charlie Rose show.
Oh, I got you. Okay. Yeah.
No, it's no accident whatsoever. Those are clearly, it was a water-themed program, and those are clearly two important aspects of dealing with water stress around the world, and they were put together intentionally. But it's amazing how siloed the world's water organizations are. Like, they are all doing great work, but they're not yet working together as much as I'd like. And that's one of the things we hope that the movie can help, you know, by telling the story of what's really going on. And we hope that people will start working together more. I think there are a growing number of groups who are trying to deal with water issues, but they seem so separate to me. I think we all need to come together on this one.
Paul Lazarus is the voice you're hearing. This is Frank McKay, but more importantly, filmmaker and director. Paul Lazarus has, we have his ear here, and we have him for a little bit of time, and we're talking about a very important film, and I don't like to editorialize that much, but this is an important film, and it's called Slingshot. And again, Paul, give the websites again where people can check out the trailer.
Yeah, you can see this. You can see the trailer, and there's also a three-minute movie we made a while back that premiered at the Sundance Film Festival, also called Slingshot. You go to www.slingshotdoc.com. That's slingshotdoc.com.
What was the reaction at Sundance?
It was pretty terrific. It was a competition called Focus Forward Films, and there were 700 films entered, and we were third place. So I like to think that's meaningful.
Yeah. Oh, no doubt about it. And all, when you talk about Focus Forward, that's the category. These are all, I would assume, world friendly, or things that that could improve the world type of films. The 700 films.
Yeah, they all were given the assignment or task to talk about an inventor, an invention, and the potential impact on the world, which is why we entered. We thought we were making a film that fits squarely into that description. But they were all extremely interesting films about so many positive actions around the world. It was an amazing group of films to be part of.
Now, what was your where did your process begin? Who turned you on to the Slingshot, and who turned you on to Dean? How did you first get involved with this?
I'm very fortunate in that for the last couple of decades, I've been making short movies for Dean, mostly about his inventions. I remember making several films about his Segway invention, which was at the time called Ginger, like Ginger Rogers, like Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's interesting.
He had made a wheelchair that went upstairs, and he nicknamed it Fred Upstairs. And so when the Segway, which was the non-disabled version of the transportation device, got invented, they called it, they nicknamed it Ginger, so because they had Fred Upstairs and Ginger. And then it got its official name, a Segway. But I first heard about, to answer your question, I first heard about Slingshot in about 2006, and it just struck me that this was potentially Dean's Kamen's most important work. And I asked him then and there, I said, this is the one we should turn the camera on and really look at a technology as it's birthing, not as it's finished. And it took about 7 or 8 years to get to now.
What was your first impression of Dean Kamen when you first met him?
He's an incredible man. He's indefatigable. He never quits working. He's dedicated to making people's lives better, and mostly does medical equipment inventions. Or, for those who don't know him, he retooled kidney dialysis. He helped invent the pumps that people use for diabetes. He invented a technology that got called autosyringe, which can give minute amounts of medicine to babies. On and on and on. Yeah, I think he has 450 foreign and U.S. patents at this point. This is the inventor's inventor and possibly the world's leading technologist. And the other great thing about Dean is he's funny. And a joy to make a movie about him, because it doesn't have to be dry. He has an incredible sense of humor, and we tried to make sure that the movie wasn't dry as dust and hopefully entertaining as well as enlightening.
Well, you hit a home run as far as that goes. I think it is. I think, again, I'm thinking bigger picture with this. My apologies, It's announcing to the world something that could be, again, a game changer, and it's brilliantly made. And Paul Lazarus is the filmmaker, and he's a director, extraordinary director. Over the years, you've seen his episodic work in shows like Friends, right? You did a number of
I've done a few TV shows in my time.
Yeah, quite a bit. This has to feel different.
Yeah, I've done a lot of what people call narrative work, where you start with a script, and everything from L.A. Law to Everybody Loves Raymond to Melrose Place to Pretty Little Liars. There's a big difference between having a script to work from and just having an idea. And, of course, you make all these plans, but what I learned about the documentary form, and particularly this movie, a lot of the journey was reacting to surprises and taking the story as it came to us, and that turned into be one of the most special aspects of making the movie, because it was the surprises and the unexpected parts that became, and on some, you know, on some level, the best stuff. So documentary is all about going with the flow, I guess.
You mentioned 800,000 as a population that may be in need of clean water. I mean, we're all in need of clean water, but you're talking about where it's problematic of not having clean. I mean, 800,000. I mean, yeah. I'd say that's.
I think that's a conservative number, because that's when you look at people are in the habit of being a little lazy and saying a billion people on the planet need clean water. You know, people, I've seen everything from 735 million to 900 million. So I feel comfortable with talking about 800,000, but that's just really identifying people have no access to clean water whatsoever.
That's where it's a crisis. It's a crisis, yeah, that 800,000.
Utter crisis. We were in Ghana, and, you know, there's water, but it's not running clean water. It's like in a bottle or a sachet. It's very popular in Africa to get water from these sachets. They're little plastic bags they call sachets, and you bite off the corner and you suck in the clean water. And we found out that a lot of those sachets are made by people who are, you know, not less than scrupulous, and they're using unclean water. So, you know, if you're from Ghana, you have to make sure you get the right sachet or you might be drinking bad water. But a lot of these kids that we were dealing with had never seen clean running water in their lives. They were startled by it, and they're used to going to a borehole to get water or getting it straight from a river, the Densu River, and letting the water collect and you know, the bioburden go down to the bottom and drink from the top or boil it, you know, or try to get it clean in some ways. There was, at their schools, a tap that they could turn on and get water provided from the slingshot device. And the power of those, of seeing those kids get that water for the first time is astonishing.
Again, another reminder, this is Frank McKay. More importantly, Paul Lazarus is our very special guest, and we're talking primarily about his latest, I don't know if it's your latest, but certainly recent release, and that's Slingshot, and you'll all be able to see it on Netflix and everyone where else. It's an incredible invention that that creates or that cleans purifies water, cleans dirty water, and makes it feasible that people in areas that have never had it before will get it. Now, having said all of that, Paul, when you document anything, I guess you want to be, obviously you always want to be accurate. With this, I imagine you want to be even more accurate, because like we said, the target, you know, a Bill Gates, it's possible that a Bill Gates is going to watch it, or a Elon Musk, or Warren Buffett, somebody like that could take this and run with this from a humanitarian standpoint, could very well come along and do this. How much extra pressure does it put on you as far as everything goes, continuity and just correctness of information?
Yeah, I mean, you feel extremely pressured about that, and I think it affected the movie in all sorts of ways. You know, we just wanted to be as factual and as accurate as we could possibly be, you know, given the wide-ranging challenge of making this movie. But we, it's not just making people laugh or cry. It's potentially helping people get clean water, or raising awareness about a crisis, or getting a technology further along and getting mass produced and distributed. So with all of that comes a feeling of responsibility, and I try not to think about that all the time, but it's not the same as making a comedy where the most you hope for is making people laugh, which I've done a lot in my life, and I really enjoy that. But this is different. This is potentially getting clean water. I saw those kids, you know, get that water in Ghana, and it makes an indelible mark on your psyche when you see that. It's hard for me to. I have an 8-year-old daughter, and she's actually gotten sensitive to this now. But even watching her brush her teeth and leaving the water on, it pains me. I can't watch that anymore, because I'm too aware of how precious this resource really is in a lot of places. So you start to become very politicized and a little bit soapbox. You know, you feel like, I feel like I get on a soapbox a lot now, but it's hard to avoid it because it's such an important problem.
All right, we got a minute left with Paul Lazarus, the creator of Slingshot, the movie. And what can you leave us with in the last minute?
I guess I'd like to leave you with the following thoughts. Water is super important. It's going to get more and more important. The Slingshot device is a really great potential solution to getting clean water to people who desperately need it. And, come see the movie or come to our website, www.slingshotdoc.com, slingshotdoc, like documentary, and join the growing number of people who are dealing with water around the world.
I'd love to do a follow-up in the future. I think it's an important film. I hate to editorialize in the middle of an interview, but it is an important film. It's brilliant, and it's a game changer. I'm absolutely convinced of that. Paul Lazarus, thanks for being here, and thanks for making this movie.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And I want to thank everyone for tuning in. We will see you next time on Breaking It Down. This is Frank McKay.